hello and welcome. And I'm so glad that you have a moment to share with us, and I hope you'll stay tuned. I have a very special person here, and we're going to talk about music and young people and how it influences our world. And Dan Turner is here, Dr. Dan Turner. Thank you for coming and sharing with us today.
Thank you so much for having me.
You received, you're the director of bands and instrumental activities right now.
Yes.
At Bob Jones University.
Yes.
And you received a doctorate from the University of Illinois.
That's right.
And another degree from Bob Jones.
Right.
So you're well prepared to do what you're doing. And music is a part of everyone's life, even if they don't think about it. For every event in our life that's important, there's music.
That's right. Music is everywhere, especially now. Any place you go to eat, music is there. You go shopping, music is there. Go to the grocery store, music is there. And all of that music is designed specifically to help the merchants have you buy more, eat faster, and so forth.
I never thought about it that way.
Not exactly the music that I've been involved in over my life. Being a band director and working with young people has changed a bit, but it is one of the most wonderful experiences that a person can have.
And it's a long time. You've had quite a career in music.
Yes, I've been teaching music for over 40 years, 44 years, and my entire career has been spent right here in Greenville at Bob Jones University. I was responsible for developing the band program for the elementary level, the junior high level, and the high school level. And then in 1983, I was asked to take the university position. And that was after I earned a master's and had started my doctorate at the University of Illinois.
So you've had, and it's been very rewarding, hasn't it?
Yes, it has. We just returned from a 10-day tour to the state of Florida where we played 14 concerts. When I say we...
Yeah, I was going to say, elaborate.
Yes. Well, when I say we, I mean the Foundation Brass, which is the brass faculty at Bob Jones. We travel several times a year giving concerts in churches and schools. And we were in Florida, got back yesterday afternoon, did 14 programs, and we were with several of our graduates. Both of them were brass players, and it had us for teachers. And it was a great experience to have them join us as we played.
Why do you, obviously you think it's important, but why do you think that the study of music is important for children? Even if, you know, not every child has talent or aims for a career in music, but the study of music adds a lot.
Oh, the study of music enriches a person's life. Especially if they move beyond what is current and popular, because everything that is popular changes, and it changes so rapidly that there's really not a consistency there. And so we would like to challenge young people to get involved in serious music that actually comes into their lives and can change how they think and how they feel. Music provides opportunities for children to express themselves in ways that they otherwise would not be able to. And in order to be good at it, it takes a tremendous amount of personal discipline. It allows children to learn to think creatively and flexibly, because unlike you know, math or history or some of the other subject matters, music has more than one solution to every problem that a student is faced with. And consequently, the student has to make intelligent choices, and those choices can vary depending on the era of time in which the music was written, or the tempo, the speed of the music, or any number of factors, who was conducting and how they want a passage to go. So it does lead to very flexible thinking.
Well, if a child, for instance, takes piano lessons, there also math is involved in that. You have to count, you have to,
right.
you know. So
right.
it isn't just, it's a widespread kind of educational tool.
It develops the entire person. It develops their ability to think critically. It develops their ability to feel in ways that they otherwise would not be able to feel. It instructs the life of emotion within man. And music is also one of the key elements in worshiping and praising God. And we're commanded yeah. to sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. And we know that Christ sang in the upper room before the crucifixion. And we know from the book of Zechariah that God sings over us with great joy. And so if God sings and if Christ sings, it seems like all of us should be singing praises as well.
That's beautiful. I like that. Well, I think every aspect of our life, as we live from childhood, a little child just saying happy birthday.
Right.
All through our life, it can be a simple little tune, but music is there.
Yes. It is one of the few things that accompanies every aspect of human life. Birth is celebrated by music. Death is celebrated
absolutely
by music. Weddings. All of the great events in a person's life are involved or have music involved with them, every one of them.
Why would you, I'd like to ask you, your advice to a parent about giving their children music lessons?
I think it's incredibly important, and I spent the first 11 years of my career working with elementary age children. It opens up a door for them to explore the world in
Bless
many
you.
Ways.
No.
There are aspects of history that can be learned through musical sound. There are aspects of, as you mentioned, mathematics, in the division of time. I mean, we're talking about dividing something that is not tangible. Time is not something that we can touch, but we all live in it. Some time is real, that is the clock, 1 hour, 60 minutes. Some time is virtual, meaning it exists only when we're involved in doing it. So if we sing a song, that is a kind of time that does not exist in the clock. We can always go back and redo it, but it will be different. And music we can relive. I guess we're kind of down into some philosophy stuff now, but children can learn this. And children can use music in wonderful ways. They can use music to express themselves, to create whole worlds that are brand new for themselves. It allows them to explore things that already exist. It's tremendous, and it's wonderful discipline. I remember my mother standing behind me with a pencil, whacking it on the chair. And when I would mess up or when I would fuss, she would whack me on the head with that pencil.
Oh, my.
But that kind of discipline doesn't come out of too many other areas of study.
I suppose not. No, but music is it's woven into the fabric of our lives.
Yes, it is.
It doesn't. I mean, you sing "Happy Birthday" to a little child on their birthday party, weddings, funerals, everything that's important in life.
Right.
There's music.
God designed it that way.
And of course, church. You go, you can be inspired.
Right.
By a hymn.
It can be both elevating or demeaning.
Well, some of the music around today, I think we could do without.
Yes, right.
Right?
Yes.
What do you think? I mean, I think of Mozart or Beethoven. That music will never die.
Right. There is something about the music of the great composers that reaches out and touches every person on the face of the earth. When Baghdad was liberated in the first Gulf War and Saddam Hussein had been removed from power, for the first time in a number of years, I can't recall exactly the number of years, whether it was 9 years or 11 years, but for the first time in that span of time, the Baghdad Orchestra, and there is an orchestra in Baghdad, the Baghdad Orchestra came together, and the piece of music that they played was Beethoven's Symphony No. 5. You know, dee-da-da-dum, da-da-da-dum, because it reaches out and it does something to the human spirit. Great art changes people. And the experience of hearing a concert, hearing great music, truly does do something to an individual. And even more so when you're involved in performing it. Recently, with the orchestra and the choir, one of the choirs at Bob Jones, we went to Orchestra Hall in Chicago and performed.
Oh, how wonderful.
And had a great audience there and got to play in the space of one of the world's great orchestras. And just being on that stage and performing where truly the most magnificent orchestra in the United States with the greatest performers in the world, that changed our students' lives
I would imagine, in certain ways.
Yeah.
We're going to go to a quick break and we'll be right back, so don't go away.